All right, perfect. Thank you, everybody. We're having some cafeito this morning. We want to thank everybody for joining our live. We have a special one today. We're going to make a couple of announcements real quick. Then we're going to show you a video of La Máquina Insular with Tito Mato. And then we're going to bring Tito onto the video and we're going to kick off our live for today.
Absolutely. You want to give me a little background music while I do a little housekeeping.
All right. So I'm going to put La Máquina Insular. The song that's on the, here it is. The song that's on the production that we select. Sorry.
All right. So we're going to get people. Or just like set me live. So we're going to give people some time to join us. Share the live with your friends. Pass it along. And in the meantime, I'm just gonna do the usual housekeeping. So, Crystal Rivera, Angel Rivera, father-daughter duo. We are with Puerto Rico Distillery over at Hughes Ford Road in Frederick, Maryland. And we have actually recently restarted doing tastings by reservation, but now that the whole family is vaccinated, yay! Yeah, except for Cece, but she's down in Puerto Rico. But now that we're all vaccinated, we are easing back into safely reopening our doors. So give us a call, you know, send an email, however, we'll set up a time for you to do a tasting. You can drop by, but there's not gonna be a guaranteed spot because we are still keeping it pretty limited in that respect. So tastings are back on. Who's our nonprofit of the month?
Multiple sclerosis. We have a nonprofit that every month we select and all the proceeds from the tastings go to that. And this month is a very worthy and important cause of multiple sclerosis. It is Multiple Sclerosis Awareness Month. So we definitely want to support them as much as we can. So please stop by and again, everything goes to them.
Yep. So there's that. As usual, you can find us on Facebook at Puerto Rico Distillery, Instagram at Puerto Rico Distillery, all spelled out, and Twitter at PR Distillery. You can always hashtag PRDMD and find us online at www.puertoricodistillery.com. So I think that is the usual stuff.
So we only have one more thing to tell you, and it is that we are very close to actually having coffee that we use to make our pitorro for you to actually make your coffee for your own consumption. It's amazing in our pitorro, so it has to be amazing just drinking it straight. Just be on the lookout for that. That's coming. Okay, so we're ready?
Yep.
All right. So we're going to share with you a video that we have of La Máquina Insular, directed by Tito Mato and his crew, just to get us warmed up. It's in La Goico, Taller Comunidad La Goico. And when once we come back, Tito's already waiting in the back room, in the waiting area, and we'll start our conversation. So enjoy.
But once again, go ahead, share with your friends.
We're just getting started here.
Here we go.
Esto es el trabajo, 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 esto es el trabajo virtual summit.
Difficulties or not.
So we have questions for you guys because we were getting some feedback that the audio was you couldn't hear the audio. So I don't know if you guys, if some of you could not hear the audio, then we'll try to figure that one out and we'll put it towards the end.
Yeah, we'll add it to the chat. Technical experts we are not.
So. And it is on our Facebook page, so you can go check it out there. So let's bring Tito into the action here real quick.
Okay. Epa.
Tito, how you doing?
Tito.
Sí, mira, está mirado.
He's hanging.
Oh, no, he's definitely hanging. he's definitely in the waiting room waiting. Mm-hmm. All right. So while we get Tito to talk, Let's share real quick. ¿No te oímos? Ahora estamos. All right.
Saludo. Well,
saludo, Tito. Welcome to our series of lives. This started as a series of artists that have come to Maryland. You have come to Maryland twice, right? And is on our production. But that is all we want to do to start. We want to actually get to meet you and we want to talk about the projects that you have going on. I can go on and on about you, but probably the best way is for you to give us a quick synopsis of your trajectory.
Perdóname, I'm sorry, because someone came on to tell me that I was sideways. So I don't know if I am correct now or not.
Yeah, you were sideways. Now you're good. Now you're good.
So let me start by saying good morning to everybody. And from Machuchal, Puerto Rico, from La Goico and the future home of La Casa de la Plena. Thank you very much for having me. Thank you to Albita, Ángel, Xiomara, Los Hijos de Plena, y toda la cultura que están haciendo ustedes allá en Maryland. Thank you very much. This idea is it's a really long, long, old idea that some members of Pleneros, very independence group in Puerto Rico called Los Sapos del Caño, we discussed many times that when we were, when we started, we were young. Now we are older, but we were thinking that we were even older than we are now, that we were going to meet back again and buy a place anywhere in Puerto Rico and create a space that pays tribute to the music form that we love, and it's called plena from Puerto Rico. And the amazing thing is that even without the hurricanes and the earthquakes and the fiscal, you know, calamity that is happening in Puerto Rico, we have found this oasis in our barrio in Machuchal named Taller Comunidad Lagoico, which wasn't, you know, a closed school that the community reached out to the state and the municipality. And last but not least, in last August, or Agosto pasado, finally they passed the ownership of the property to us, to Taller Comunidad Lagoico, which is a 501c3, a non-for-profit community and cultural organization. Inside this space, I found this around 600 square foot of empty space that I rapidly became in love because of the, you know, they did some, they changed the facade to accommodate for a un almacén, como se dice un almacén, like a big storage space. And I saw that big metal door, roll up door, like for a good place for a mural. And as soon as I came into the space, the whole idea of Casa de la Plena came back to my mind. I said, man, this is a good starting point to create a place that pays tribute to the music that we love. And then even without planning about it, everything came together in a sad and happy way, because master plenero and anthropologist Ramon Lopez just passed away. It's going to be a year pretty soon. And he was one of my masters. And before he passed away, he basically made me the custodian of his plena collection, meaning 100 plus CDs, a couple of tapices, all his craft artesanías, little pleneros, little pleneras, books. And so then, I mean, the idea of Casa de la Plena became now a reality, because the most important part of it, the heart of it, is that collection. And that's already here. The walls that we are trying to fix is just, you know, it's the space that is going to harbor that amazing collection. But the heart of Casa de la Plena is already happening. It's already here. It just needs a painted and a more refreshed space. But I am on top of it. We already covered, I took out all the pizarras, all the old pizarras, and a TV mounted bracket that was there. I took it out, I cleaned it, and the roof is already painted. I already did all the inserts for the anchorage of the tapices wall and panderetas wall that is going to divide the space in a way, because I want the people, even though it's very small, I want people to walk through in a way, you know, that can see the tapices, can also see the graphic art that we have, including two of the main carteles of Tufiño from La Plena. I have two at home that are going to be brought here. I also have the mural of La Plena that is shown at the Museum of Puerto Rico, Art of Puerto Rico, the big one. I have one given to me by Tufiño's son as a gift. And it's a signed complete mural on a scale. So it's smaller, but it's going to also be here. And I mean, that's basically the story behind Casa de la Plena and how we're going about it. And again, I already started because I cannot be quiet, you know, I need to move.
We know.
And we are also doing very, very plenistic stuff, because pleneros, we are the masters
Pleneros and pleneras, we are the masters of recycling. So instead of doing a big wooden shell, very expensive, we are going to recycle these, and these are going to be our CD brackets and books brackets. They are going to be spread out. And I already ordered the CD players because the collection of Ramon is all in CDs. So we are going to mount 3 CD players that people can choose whatever album of Fortijo or Pleneros or Los Hijos de Plena or the Puerto Rico de Tio. Let me listen to that. And then it's going to be a reading book section, and then a section where we are going to have 3 monitors of 3 small smart TVs where we can show the 3 main documentaries done about La Plena, the one from Amilcar Tirado in the 50s, the ones of Pedro Rivera in the 80s, and then Plenazos Callejeros, which is the one that me and Mariana did, and I think that that came out, I don't even remember, maybe 2014, something like that, because Plenazos Callejeros ended in 2012, from 2005 to 2012, 7 years. So the documentary maybe is from 2012, 2014, one of those years. Mariana should remember better than me. But in a condensed way, I think that I already mentioned all about Casa de la Plena.
Es un montón de trabajo.
No, yeah, it's a lot. So a couple things. So we're gonna mention some folks, and I know that you guys have done a lot of work, but there's also a lot more work that has to be done. And you guys have some financial needs. So I'm gonna ask, I know Xiomara, Joelo that have been helping us out have the QR code on how to actually reach and donate to La Casa de la Plena, right? So I'm gonna ask them to share that. So people like Lisette de Kansas, David, Ramais, Ibeliz, Dia de allá en Chicago, Alejandro Coto, Osvaldo Cruz, Luis Berrío, Randy Sotomayor, Heitza, Cano y Mari Arroyo, toda esa gente can see the QR code and actually jump in and help out this great cause. We do want to announce real quick that Puerto Rico Distillery has a donation program, and we are putting forth a matching challenge right now to everybody that's watching this video. That of $500. So the first $500 that people donate, we will match that and give an additional $500. So we have, Mariana tuned in to see those great donations come in. You can donate in 2 different ways. When you go on there, you can donate a recurring, because they're gonna have a financial recurring need to pay for the rent for the space. So you can sign up to give $5 a month and set it and forget it. And it's just a cup of coffee a month, but you'll still be helping out a lot. Entre todo el mundo, right? Between everybody, we can help keep the space open. They also have a need for all the work that's going on right now, right? So you can also donate one time, a one-time donation to contribute to all the work that Tito is talking about now. So
I will.
Right now we have the donation matching. So if you want your, you know, whether it's $1, $10, however much you can afford to give, if you want to double it, this is a perfect time for that.
And I just want to say that it will be good if for the donation that you want to send to explicitly say for Casa de la Plena, because there are some other donations destinated to the small library that we are trying to open. And we don't want to confuse those with ours. And I mean, it's all going to the Taller Comunidad Lagoico, but it's very important specifically because in here, we need to sort that out. And yeah. Again, I am very, very happy and very agradecido, muy, muy agradecido, very thankful from all your support, not now. I mean, this is long way back, our relationship with you guys, especially Angel Albita, y los hijos de Plena, y de verdad que en algún momento tendremos la oportunidad de revertir todo eso para allá también, y estamos súper agradecidos.
Gracias a ti. So as follow up to that, Tito has been a mentor to us for a very long time, right? So actually, before I say that, I'm going to look over to Albita and ask Albita to go on to use that QR code to go on there. We are doing the $500 match, but we also want to contribute monthly. So I'm gonna
ask, oh, you mean as a family?
As a family, right. Mm-hmm. So I'm gonna donate $5 for Kriti, for myself, for Xiomara, and for Arbita. So $20 a month, set it and forget it. And to help, and every little bit counts. Okay.
There we go, we're walking the walk.
Yeah. No, we're talking and walking the walk. But going back to Tito has been a mentor to us here in Maryland. A lot of the work that Cultura Planeta has done for the community here in Maryland started with Tito and Juango de Los Planos de la 21. We went to them and we told them that we wanted to serve our community the same way that Tito is serving his community in Puerto Rico and Juango is serving his community in New York. And they were more than open. They've been here both on several occasions to help us out. So you don't owe us anything. We're just going to keep working together. De aquí allá en la diáspora en Puerto Rico, it doesn't matter. So while the donations start rolling in, we're going to start mentioning people as they start contributing. Can you tell us a little bit about Ramón López, right? So you said the heart of el museo, la Casa de la Plena, no museo. La Casa de la Plena is going to be what Ramón López gave you, there's a lot of information that he has from studies that he's done. So I'm assuming that it's going to be just a wealth of knowledge. Can you talk a little bit about what treasures are in his collection?
I don't think there is a scholar in Puerto Rico that was more connected to the Plena tradition than Ramón. And he saw it both with, he had the possibility and the knowledge and the eloquence to see it and interpret Plena, not only from the anthropology point of view, but also as a master artisan doing tapices, and as a master Plena composer and member of Pleneros de la 23 Abajo. That's how I met Ramón. I met Ramón in the 80s, early 80s, when I was a member of Pleneros del Pueblo. And it was basically, if you got into Pleneros del Pueblo, that was the direct route to become a member of Pleneros la 23 Abajo, which is a legendary group in Puerto Rico. And Ramón was already a member of that group. He was already doing tapices. He was already writing at Claridad. The amount, it's not only the amount of CDs. He was a scholar, so these CDs were well treated. You see my CDs, they are all scratched. You cannot listen to, you know, these cities are in good mint condition, and people are going to, and I already have a good friend of mine, architect Ramon, his name is Ramon also. He's helping me digitalizing all this music. I mean, it's digitalized, it's in a CD, but to create una biblioteca auditiva, you know, like audio, reference of all those CDs. We are already starting that. In terms of books, you can imagine he wrote what is to me the second best now, because there is a new book from Rafaela Ponte Lede, which was well connected with Ramón in terms of how they saw music and how they saw the experience of La Plena in Puerto Rico. And I love those two books, Los Bembeteos de la Plena, que es el de Ramón López. By the way, he had like two or three boxes of unsold books that are going to be available here for people who want it. So those are going to be part of the collection, in addition to the books that I already got, like the classic of Francisco Echevarría, La Plena, el profesor Emmanuel Dufresne, Puerto Rico Tiene Tambor, etcétera, etcétera. Me acaban de decir que we just got the first donation from Nicole Perosier from Washington, D.C. So thank you very much. We really appreciate, Nicole, your donation. What else? Mariana me acaba de decir que es un montón de chavos. Well, God bless, Nicole. He said, we don't care if he's tiny or big, but, you know, that means that when you come here, I'm going to give you a tour of the Casa de la Plena, including also, I am deviating like always. We also have a project that people can just click when we finish this conversation. It's called Plena Cangrejera. And that was a photographic tribute, like an outside photographic tribute of Plena masters from Santurce, or Plena groups from Santurce, or Plena spaces that were important in a period of time. Mm-hmm. And that was all posted in Calle Loiza, but it got, because of vandalism and a lot of stuff, it got broken up. There's like two or three still there out of the 15 stations, but I reprinted those, and those are already plastered in, posted in the outside walls of Taller Comunidad Lagoico. So in the future, when we do the musical parade visiting each of the stations, playing the music of each of those masters, we are going to end up the tour here in Casa de la Plena. So, I mean, it's going to be a complete experience. I don't want to exaggerate, but I think it's going to be the first space in Puerto Rico and everywhere dedicated to La Plena, because not even the Institute of Cultura of Puerto Rico, they have some spaces dedicated to Puerto Rican music, and they might have an African corner with some panderetas and some barrels, but there is not a unique space dedicated only to La Plena. So in that sense, we are doing something important. And in terms of the community, it's also very important because we are going very rapidly through gentrification, especially now with the laws that are advancing that influx of money from outside, that is rapidly changing the identity, not the identity, but it's trying to change the identity of the community. So spaces like this, when we pay tribute to the music of the originals of Machuchal, of San Mateo de Cangrejo, when we, you know, that we are teaching to women, kids, every Wednesday, bomba and plena here in this space, is in a way, is we are putting a flag, or we are trying to put a stop to that. And even if you take everything outside in this bubble, this is going to represent La Plena, this is going to represent Machuchal, this is going to represent San Mateo de Cangrejo.
So can you tell people that might not be familiar with the area where it's going to be located, because it's going to be a live space that people can visit, right? So everybody from the diaspora, when they land in San Juan,
I am hoping to retire here. I am hoping to you know that this becomes so famous, not famous in that sense, but that I can support my family honestly and dignifiedly by paying tribute to the music that I love. Can you imagine that? Mm-hmm. That would be amazing. That's the plan. But you know, we have been struggling with this music for 40 years. And we know that it's not, the ideas are cool, and not everything runs parallel to that. So, I mean, we are aiming high like always, but the process is the beautiful part. Just being here, if I am really mad, I come inside of this room and take my rollo and start to paint, And I know what it's going to look in the future. That makes me happy.
Absolutely. This is really resonating with people. We have people in the chat saying, Sami from Details Matter, and thanking you for opening your doors to them. Jonathan Rodriguez de Carolina y la esposa de Arecibo, que viven en Baltimore, our neighbors over there. Ashley Sky is tuning in. Lisette says, community breeds life. So a lot of love, a lot of connection with all this.
Absolutely. So what's the address for La Goico? Because La Casa de la Plena is inside La Goico, right? So what's the address for people to get there?
I'm sorry, I had to keep turning the sun away from the camera.
I have my son Marcelo doing the running between where Mariana is and where I am. And he's the one sending me the notes from Mariana. We need to send also Joel Cruz, Melanie Rivera, y Angel Rivera, y Alejandro Cotto, some additional donors that are participating. And this feels really awkward to me because you know me, it doesn't feel right to me, begging. It doesn't.
It's not begging though. It's providing a service and it's a value to the community.
It's definitely not. It's definitely not begging, right? It's the fact that you have thrown on your shoulders a lot of work that unless we all collectively share in that load, it's not going to exist. It's just not going to exist. Right.
And we can't have that.
And we want that. So I don't know if I ever told you this, but the same dream that you have of La Casa de la Plena, I had, and I told Albita, yo me quiero ir para Puerto Rico and contribute to that. I didn't know you were going to be the person to eventually make it a reality. And we can't, and even though we try to support Puerto Rico as much as we can, and we go back to the island as much as we can, we cannot do what you are doing because you're there physically presently. So a way for us to contribute, and it might feel awkward, is financially, right? So I think that is just the reality of it, right? Nobody gets bothered when Budweiser gives a lot of money to a this cause or that cause, and really Budweiser is not going to give a lot of money to Plena. Really, this is for the community and it should come from the community. We are part of the community, as it was said earlier, and so we want to contribute. So that we can definitely set that aside, and we want to encourage people. We want everybody that's on here to if they can, contribute either recurringly or a one-time, and we want you to share this with everybody that you know and ask them to do it, right? Because unless we as a community come together and help out, it's not going to exist. And if it doesn't exist, it's really our fault for not having a champion like you that's willing to do it and helping you do it.
Also,
thank you.
From Details Matter just made an announcement that they are gonna be matching 250. So this is just gonna keep going. This is important work.
Yeah.
Listen, I forgot to, when I diverted from Ramon to the back to this, I forgot to mention that
she wants to be close by.
We're hiding from the glare.
Ramon se tiene que estar super feliz porque por razones obvias de su obra de tapices que necesitan un cuidado específico. Pues la mayoría de esos tapices van a permanecer en el Museo del Instituto de Cultura y de otras instituciones con las cuales luchó mucho. Entonces, saber que esa colección de él se va a quedar aquí, en este espacio que es rescatado por la comunidad. Yo no puedo decir esto en inglés, ustedes van a tener que traducirlo. Es un honor, es una alegría, pero también una responsabilidad absoluta que yo tengo con él, de asegurarme de que ese legado se presente aquí de la manera más digna posible y con el mayor de los respetos a todas a todos esos que vinieron antes que nosotros y que como él dejaron ese legado y a lo mejor no tuvieron la oportunidad de pasarlo para adelante. Así que eso no lo puedo traducir, eso lo van a tener que traducir ustedes. Disculpen. Yeah.
No, thank you for that. So for those that don't know Spanish, Tito was just sharing how important it is for him to be the custodian of the material that Ramon López left for him to be a custodian of. And the fact that La Casa de la Plena is becoming a reality is going to be a home for that important material. And just going back to the point that you were saying earlier, Tito, it is unfortunate that we don't have more people like Ramon López, right? Because we know that these come from legacies that are spoken. Traditionally, they've been handed down from generation to generation. But even though there's beauty in that, there's also an issue with that, which is that it is hard to maintain, especially in times where information is just bombarding everybody. And people like Ramon have been able to actually document that. So then when people like us want to just go to the source or go to a place that has that repository of knowledge, then we can go to it. So thank you. Thank you for that. We know we have the music, we have the books. You also have some other things that are not from Ramon. Is that correct? You have your collection of CDs.
Yeah.
I mean, of panderos, panderetas.
Yeah. I mean, the main thing is Ramon's, no doubt about it. But the biggest pandereta collection in the world, panderetas of Plena, I think is on my hands. I know that you're trying to match me, but I don't know if you're going to get I have 100 plus panderetas, not including from many artisans from the diaspora and from Puerto Rico. I also have traditional instruments of La Plena, like tumbandero made out of aluminum washtub base, tumbandero made out of a paint bucket, a 5-gallon paint bucket. Mm-hmm. I have marimbola. I have timbita de Plena. I have the original instrument that provoked el 2-pa-1 of Jorge Martinez. I have the first version. It's called el pandón, made by another master who passed away in Massachusetts, Don Miguel Almestica, founder of Los Pleneros del Coco. And he was the creator of the instrument, and he named it, which to me is a beautiful name for a new instrument, el pandón. And so all those instruments are there also to be part of the collection. We are already doing a search, and from our friends in the diaspora that collect art from that generation in Puerto Rico, you might have it. And if you might have it and we cannot buy it, at least we want to borrow it, you know, with a contract. We are looking for La Plena collection made by Lorenzo Mar and Tufino. Those are like 11 by 17 small lithographies that have Plena songs. A small image like Cortaron Elena and the Plena song with the pentagram. And they're like 12-piece collection set. We are looking for it hardly because we wanted to be part of the collection of Casa de la Plena. And even if we cannot have it, own it, at least we want to have it so people can see it. And so if someone in the diaspora have it and want to borrow that collection, we will make sure that it's well treated and it will be appreciated here in Casa de la Plena also. Mm-hmm. But yes, contestando tu pregunta, yeah, it's going to be a mixture of Ramon stuff and some of the stuff that I have.
Okay, perfect. So I'm going to ask again, Joelo, Xiomara, whoever has the QR code, to share it again for those that might have joined us later also, in the video. Sí.
Also, I don't know if I am assuming that Mariana is connected because she's sending me these notes.
I don't know how to put, this is not the final idea for the outside logo, the outside mural on the metal wall, but I think the artist send us like a quick preview or on what he's working on. I don't know if you remember that I was mentioning to you that the letterings, the typography of Casa de la Plena wants to pay tribute precisely at the graphic art of that era. Mm-hmm. So the logo is going to look like those affiches, those serigraphies. Right. But the image that he sent me, I have it on my phone, but I am scared that if I look for it, I'm going to be cut out of the connection. So maybe I can send it to you back later.
Yeah, right, we'll do it as a follow-up.
No, we definitely would love to see that. So again, keep share. Let's share if it hasn't been done yet. The QR code, get people going. So we can. Yep. Yes, you have announcements.
Joselo is saying that he don't know how to put the QR code live.
It's not a QR code; it's a link.
Yeah. Okay. Hey, yeah.
Is the link in the chat?
There is a link in the chat.
All right. Can you pin it?
And also, I have a few more thanks to Carla Minet, to Leslie Net, Carrucini.
Carrucini, la prima.
Oh, prima mía también.
Sí.
Jonathan Rodríguez y Rafael Matos de Maryland. Si es Matos, tiene que ser bueno.
Gracias, Jonathan. Siempre apoyando la cultura, bien, bien chévere.
So, okay. If you go to the chat in the Facebook, this is an announcement to everyone. You go to the chat, PRD has pinned the link. So if you see a pinned comment, that's the link to the donation.
Okay.
Which there are people making donations. Gracias. So keep it going.
Yeah, and remember to put in the comments that it's for La Casa de la Plena.
Yeah, that's pretty common in nonprofits, a way of earmarking what you want that to go to. So just earmark it. Oh, okay. So Mas actually forgot to do that, but I guess we have to donate again.
Okay, so these are for announcements for us.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of love.
Yeah,
chat,
sí, hay un montón de gente que está ahí apoyando, siempre apoyar a la plena. Alejandro Cruz, Axel de la R, está conectado también. Ramirez Stage, la GoCo es un espacio comunitario importante en el área de Metro, and that is absolutely true. Mela, de la Presidenta de Cultura Plenera, Amazing Educational Initiative. Rosanne Duchatne, gracias Tito por la visión y proteger el legado. Joelo, nos quitamos el sombrero. Everybody's just so, everybody wishes they would do it, they had the opportunity to do it themselves. But you, like you said in the video that we shared a little bit of a video that showed the space full of material and you talking about your plans and you mentioning that you were the youngest of the three that had the original idea. And we definitely want to support you and give you the tools to do that. So another question, so we can keep talking and people can keep getting information. It looks like you have an announcement. So Zumba, y después voy yo.
Okay, so Mariana came herself. We just reached $1,200. So we have 1,200 pesos ya. Thank you to David Ramis, Diego Lopez, and Wilda Rivera. So thank you very much, everyone. Ching, 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 ching.
Sí, sí.
Me gusta.
We. Ese es mi comay. Así que está mucha gente que nos apoya a nosotros, que obviamente saben que lo que está haciendo es importante. José Ocasio, que es uno de los HP. Y David fue el que nos trajo la idea de, nos recomendó que apoyáramos Multiple Sclerosis este mes. Y estamos muy agradecidos con esa idea. Y con el apoyo que siempre nos ha dado a nosotros, así que lo que estamos es ayudándonos unos a los otros, right? That's part of community. The beauty of community is that I help you, you help me, and between all of us, we're at the end, we're better off.
We're in it together.
We're definitely are in it together. So Tito, you've said that a couple of times, and I wanna talk about this a little bit. You said this is not a museum, even though there's gonna be a lot of information in there for people to just go and learn about the plena. But it's gonna be a live space. So your intent is to have workshops. Your intent is to have performances. And can you talk about that part of it, right? So La Plena Viva.
Yeah. I don't like the term museum at all. I mean, it's just it's not La Plena at all. So they are really different stuff. And if I am doing something important, if I have done something important or significant on La Plena, it's basically erasing that hegemonic idea, the state idea of folklorism. This is live popular music, as simple as that. We are just not as popular as reggaeton, but it's the same beat. Same beat. And maybe if I paint my hair pink, then maybe I become famous. But what I'm saying is, this is a live space. It's important to have the history. Whatever little or much is written is going to be there. The sound history, whatever is recorded, we are going to try to have it there. The three videos, that part is very important because there is a disconnect. Historically, there is no school in Puerto Rico where you can learn about bomba and plena. And when I grew up, there is just two. La de Modesto, or maybe tú tenías que ir a Isabel Albizu a Ponce, ¿sabes? Just a few. Nowadays, it's different. And that's where the people in my generation have broken the seal. Mm-hmm. It's become more democratic. And in that sense, I think this space has to be like that. Open, democratic, available. The Casa de la Plena, instead of museum, is because of that. It's home. It's home. Pleneros and pleneras and pleneres, whatever you want to call it, now have a space here in San Mateo de Cangrejo. We don't need to go to any other place. It's going to be here. And you're going to feel at home. Going back to the question, because of Ramon collection, we need to that part of the history to educate, because there is so much misunderstanding about our tradition. And also there is going to be like a small stage where visitors, artists that are visiting Puerto Rico, or maybe from Mayagüez, I invite Alex or Kili Viali para que vengan a dar un taller de la plena mayagüezana, que aquí here in Santurce there's still many not misunderstanding, just those people don't know about the difference. So we are going to have, I can invite Ramon Pedraza. He's no longer playing music outside because now he's invested on, he's in the church now. But he said to me that he's hoping to come here and do a workshop on how he does panderetas. That's a luxury. Mm-hmm. And that is going to happen here. Hopefully we are going to have programming for, every day something different, hopefully, But if not, we are going to start like we started with La Plena Cangrejera. We did one tour a month. If the movement of the space require me to do more stuff and inviting more people, that's going to happen. That's very organic. But we need to, go little by little. The first thing was finding the place. Now we got it. Now starting to do the work. I am 30% done in terms of construction, because the most difficult part was this wall and electricity, and that was done this week. The rest is just cosmetic, and installing the electronic equipment that is coming, I want to order today some of that stuff. And then the intricacy of this, you cannot see it, but like in here, like L shape, there is going to be a quartz like this, que van a que they are going to fall down like a curtain from roof to floor, in a way mimicking the same quadricula of tapices from Ramón. It's like also keeping on that idea. And on one side, it's going to be one of tapices de Ramón. On the other side, it's going to be an amplified picture of Roberto Cipriani dancing with Milly Baré, members of Pleneros de la 23 Abajo. And then on that side is going to be the small stage, the Ramón López stage. We already named it and we are going to, I was thinking in painting, but that's too much work. A good friend of mine came and he gave me idea. There is this D panels, plastic, white, like 1/4 inch. And they sell in 4x8 cheaper. What I'm going to do is I'm going to plug all those and fill all that back wall, metal, the backside of the metal roll up door with those plastic D panels so we can project with my projector documentaries or whatever additional stuff the invited guest brings for the charla or for. It's going to be small, but it's going to be equipped to do all those stuff.
Yeah, and everything that you were mentioning there, again, it requires an investment, right? So, for example, you were talking about bringing Plenero de Mayagüez. Ideally, they don't have to to come on their own dime, right? So that's why it's important that you support financially these types of things. The last note that I have, I'm not sure if you have a different number, Tito, but we're at 1,226. So obviously the match that we had committed, you're going to get our matching contribution.
The details matter.
And the details matter. So we definitely, I think we're doing well. I'm looking forward to going to Puerto Rico and visiting La Casa de la Plena. So when we go there, are you going to have like the documentary CDs for available for purchase and other things, or because you've talked about, well, we can go and watch the videos. What else is going to so people can put this on their next trip? Cuando vaya a Puerto Rico, voy a parar en la Casa de la Plena, and I'm going to be able to do this and that. Maybe get a T-shirt de la Casa de la Plena to come back and prove that I was there. Una foto contigo.
I need to work on all that. I need to work on all that. At this point, I am focused on construction because I am alone, honestly, and there is work to be done. Hopefully, when the logo is ready, then I can ask my local artist Yolanda or Jose Luis, and we can send for teachers on and that. In terms of the documentaries, the first two, if remember correctly, they were never produced to be sold. So they just pieces of documentary. Ours, we did produce it, some of them, and they sold out and we haven't sent for more. Hopefully, mm-hmm. when they start moving, we can ask. And using this platform, all you pleneros and pleneras, who have productions and want to send a few copies, we will send that, take the percent for the stage and send your money back like every other store. In the same way for artisans, you make panderetas or guiro in the island or the diaspora and you want to have some pieces shown here and to be sold, we will welcome that. Of course, it's La Casa de la Plena. That's the reason why we have this.
No, absolutely. So, and I mean, I have my copy, right? I have my copy of Plenazo Callejero, and this is one of the three videos, that documentaries that you're going to have there. I am sure that people that watch this documentary are going to want to take one home. And that's why I mentioned it. Another example of the work that Tito has done over time is, this is a Sonido Primario, right? So the education of this culture and this music, is it doesn't start when ideally it doesn't start when you're already grown up and you can actually go to the workshops yourself. But this is an excellent example of a production that you've done to share a bomba en plena, right, with the younger generation. And this is something that I'm sure that parents that are in the diaspora, when they stop, they go to visit and they go to La Casa de la Plena and they check it out, they're gonna want a copy. So that was all I was suggesting the idea, right?
So no, I got you. And we will all, I mean, Fruta Madura, de Puerto Rico al Mundo, y Sonidos Primarios, and the one and only album from Pleneros de la 23 Abajo, we still have copies. So if people come in the beginning of Casa de la Plena, we will have the opportunity to sell some of those. Right. Opus 4 and Documental Plenazos Callejeros, I have no copies. I have to send for those. But right. Again, of course, this is going to be part of Casa de la Plena. Let me say thank you also to Janet Figueroa, Rosana Duquesne. Rosana, un abrazo. Esa es hermana de Ramón López, una de las responsables también de que estas cosas bonitas con La Plena y con el trabajo del Ramón y esa validación estén pasando. Saludo a Lizeth Cruz y a mi hermanito plenero de la ciudad de Nueva York, Julio Colón, que está ahí en el Bronx conectado.
Qué chévere. No, so a lot of what you're saying right now. So for example, what you were saying right now, one of the things that I do when I go to CD store.
Adriana, saluda.
Is just to I basically go through CDs to see if I can find a Plena or Bomba CD that I don't have. It would be a beautiful thing if anybody that is un fiebre como yo, right, can knows that if they're looking for anything they don't have, that you have it, right? That's the place to go.
Yeah. For instance, let me give you one good example. There is a piece that William Cepeda did a couple of years back. It's an amazing encyclopedia about Puerto Rican music. He has 4 books in the small encyclopedia, all the drawings by master painter artist Samuel Lin from Loíza, the research by Mareya Quintero, my teacher now. I am doing a master degree in La UP because I have that much time to spend. So my teacher, who is ¿cómo se llama? An expert on cultural and tradition, etc. She was one of the writers of the encyclopedia with William Cepeda. That collection is going to be here. Something happened here. That collection is going to be part of what we are offering in Casa de la Plena. And the good thing about it is that there is a book, but you have 2 DVDs and 2 CDs that have music related to that form of music that the book or the volume is, you know, if it's for danza, for bomba, plena, and I think the other one is bailes tradicionales. Oh, jíbaro. Mm-hmm. Bomba, plena, jíbaro, and that's, they made like a few hundred copies of those, and they, not everybody has it. I got it. And that's going to be part of it. And that's one of the unique pieces that people are going to have to chance to check out here, that maybe it will be impossible to find it. For instance, the same book of La Plena, Feli Echevarria, that's out of print for many years. And the few copies that you find there is really a rare book now. And we have it already. So they're going to find very unique pieces here. I have a requinto signed by Sammy Tanco. My father also in Sammy, all the health for you. Okay? También le dio una cosa del corazón reciente a Sammy. No está muy bien de salud. Pero Sammy me firmó esa pandereta. He signed this pandereta. It's heavy like hell because it's not a pandereta. It's a banjo. For you guys in the diaspora, you most know already, but I mean, it's part of the Puerto Ricans, pleneros and pleneras who went to the States to live and who didn't find an artisan who could make a pandereta for them.
but they passed in front of the pawn shop who had a banjo, and they bought the banjo, broke the neck, and they had the pandereta. And that's one of my precious panderetas that I have here in the collection is that one, because it contains all the movement Puerto Ricans from here to there, how they solve the plena issue. And then on top, the cherry on top of the cake, signed by one of my masters and my elders. All those are going to be part of the collection that we are going to show here.
That's amazing. This hour has flown by and we've all actually gotten a lot done. Thanks to everyone who's tuned in and made a donation. Last count that I have is 1,226 plus the PRD matching 500, Details Matter matching 250, and then Joelo's matching 500. That's another 1,250. So hopefully this is just the start of many good things to keep coming. We have to go open up the distillery, but thank you so much for joining us and for sharing and for everything that you do.
I need to say thanks again to you guys, because again, this is a community. I understand that. I got it, but it still hits you. So for those of you who contribute and who maybe didn't contribute, maybe this is not the time, but when you come and visit, you will feel it. That's all I'm saying. It's at the bottom, you know, we need it, but bottom line is going to happen anyway. You know, it's going to happen. By April, I'm pushing hard. So in the middle of April, hopefully we are already open, maybe not fully open, but doing workshops and doing stuff here. Because it's important, especially for you guys and some other members like Roberta Singer, and a musicology and friend of Pleneros for many years. She also sent some money. That's why I started here with the money that she sent. So it's really amazing. The family that we have created through La Plena, and all the tribute is to La Plena. That's the most important part. It's not about Angel, Alita, me, Viento de Agua, La Máquina, or Pleneros, whatever. It's about La Plena. It's been always been like that, and I intend to keep it that way. Thank you very much. Un abrazo. Y después nos tomamos un clandestino de eso para enjoyar.
Sí, sí, sí. We are going the first half of April, so we will see you there at La Casa de la Plena. I want to encourage everybody to visit. I want to encourage everybody to keep knowing, learning more about it. Tito, keep us informed. We'll keep sharing your progress, and we definitely want to support you. Thank you, everybody that joined us. Thank you, everybody that contributed. Thank you, everybody that shared. Again, every little bit counts. Even just tuning in just helps get the word out. Absolutely. So thank you very much. We're going to go open a distillery, drink some rum. We have Chef Santos coming over. So if you're in the diaspora.
Yeah. I'm going to open my first one. Salud. I love you. Gracias.
Gracias a ti.
Gracias a ti. Te me cuida. Okay, thank you, everybody.
Un abrazo a todos y todas.
Do we
jam out?
Yeah. With the toast?
Yeah. Vamos a estar pitoros de nosotros. Vamos a tomarnos un poquito de nosotros porque tenemos medalla, ¿sabe? Pero porque ya llegó acá. Yo sé que puede que no sepan igual, pero mira, si tú tenías un jingo ahí de, yeah. Tú tenías un jingo de clandestino que me tocaste la última vez.
¿Cuál fue?
No quiero vodka, tequila ni vino. Lo que yo quiero es un poco de clandestino.
Se me había olvidado. No quiero vodka, tequila ni vino. Lo que yo quiero es un poco de clandestino. Que baje por la garganta, se siente fino. Oye, caña de Maryland, ese clandestino. No quiero
vodka, tequila ni vino. Lo que yo quiero es un poco. Gracias, mi hermano. Te cuida.
Saludos. Salud.
Dale, un abrazote.
Bye. Bye.
Un beso a Albita.
Sí, te lo doy.